Well, the death toll growing to 50 overnight. Emergency workers are tending to scores of the injured this morning in Las Vegas. Authorities say a 64-year-old man took aim at a crowd of concert goers on the Strip.
Police confirm the shooter fired an automatic weapon into the crowd from the 32nd floor of the Mandalay Bay Hotel. NBC's Jay Gray has the latest from Las Vegas.
Chaos and fear as gunfire explodes on the Vegas Strip. A wave of automatic gunfire poured into a crowd of concert goers across from Vegas's Mandalay Bay Hotel.
I was sitting out here on the sidewalk, and all of a sudden there was fireworks, and then I saw a window come out and glass shatter everywhere, and then two or three more windows came out, and then an open machine gun fire out that direction.
There were so many people running in so many directions, and it was so scary.
At least 50 are dead, more than 200 injured, and officials fear that number could climb. Dozens rushed to a nearby hospital, many in critical condition.
But we are looking in an excess of 50 individuals dead and over 200 individuals injured.
Police say one gunman carried out the shooting, taken down by tactical officers in the chaos of the attack.
We determined there was a shooter on the 32nd floor of the Mandalay Bay. Officers responded to that location and engaged the suspect at that location. He is dead currently.
64-year-old Stephen Paddock of Mesquite, Nevada has been identified as the lone gunman. Now the famed Vegas Strip dealing with the aftermath of the nation's latest mass shooting. Jay Gray, NBC News, Las Vegas.
Well, the developments have been coming in quickly overnight, as well as dramatic video from the moment of that shooting.
Yeah, Melissa Colorado has been tracking the latest information. So what can you tell us now, Melissa?
Well, Kim and Tim, Las Vegas police, they have located Mary Lou Danley. This is a 62-year-old woman believed to have been the lone gunman's roommate. And police will be questioning her to know if she knew anything about the attack and if she potentially had any role in it. And the video being shared on social media paints a picture of the horror that unfolded last night. Now, this was the finale of a three-day country music festival on the Las Vegas Strip. Singer Jason Aldean, he was performing. He was in the middle of a song when suddenly gunfire erupted. Take a look. Can hear that gunfire, and concert goers say they initially thought the shots were fireworks. Again, at least 50 people were killed. Over 200 people are injured. Police say the shooter was 64-year-old Stephen Paddock. NBC News reports police shot Paddock in his hotel room on the 32nd floor of the Mandalay Bay Hotel. Authorities found several weapons in his hotel room. It's still not clear what those weapons were and how much ammunition the shooter had on him. As we've mentioned, this is the deadliest mass shooting in U.S. history, and it's not just traumatic for victims, but for police as well. Here's what the sheriff in Las Vegas told reporters earlier this morning.
We're holding up, and we're going to do the best we can. And I don't want to say that's what we're paid to do. It's because nobody's paid to do what we're experiencing right now. But in my preview of the police department, they're doing a fantastic job, and we're going to have to look out for their well-being moving forward.
And with at least 50 people dead, authorities are still working on identifying the victims. One off-duty police officer is among the dead. Another police officer is in critical condition. And you can only imagine what families of these concert goers, what they are going through. Families desperate to find their loved ones. They are being told to go to police headquarters for updates on those victims. And NBC News reports police are now searching Paddock's home in Mesquite, Nevada. That is a city about an hour northeast of Las Vegas. No word yet on the motive and no word on what exactly his roommate might have been telling police. Guys.
Melissa, thank you.
You know, Melissa just mentioned the families, all the people that were at that concert and what they're going through. Well, this morning, we're hearing from a local family who went to Vegas specifically for that concert.
They reached out to you. You spoke with them. I mean, we just heard that gunfire, just shot after shot after shot. Is everybody okay in this family?
Yes, that's the good news. Everybody's okay. They're all still very shaken. I can tell in her voice she was still very shaken, even explaining and reliving these horrific events. But who I spoke to was Taylor Dombrowski. She's from Cold Spring. She was at the concert with her fiance, her brother, and sister-in-law. They were all safe right now, and as I mentioned, still shaken after a horrific evening. She told me they watched a few other bands earlier in the night and decided to stay for the headliner, Jason Aldean. And after just a few songs, they heard what they thought were fireworks.
We had heard a couple of bangs go off, and I remember turning around to my fiance, Justin, and looking at him, and I said, what was that? And then we heard it again and thought that they were like big fireworks going off, maybe. We could see like what looked like big, huge firecrackers, like being thrown up in the air or going off right in the crowd. And then it just kept going. And then we realized that it was gunfire coming at us.
Now, this picture you see here was taken at the concert last night. Before the shooting happened, Taylor said they ran about 4 miles in the opposite direction of where the shots were fired, finally making it safe back to their hotel. Now, she said that group of friends and family, they just love going to concerts. They're avid sports fans of the Twins here in Minnesota. They don't want this tragedy to stop them from living life. Again, they're all safe, and they're going to take it day by day. They have a flight tomorrow back to Minnesota. But again, they're just so shaken after this. It's just no words.
A lot of people will be evaluating how they are in a mass crowd situation.
I mean, yeah.
We've seen this happen over and over.
She said even when they got back to the hotel and seeing people just standing there, they're on edge, and they're just very aware of their surroundings and who's around them.
And you told us in our last half hour that it was just good fortune for them that they happened to be at the other end of this concert.
They said it looked like firecrackers in the air, and they had no idea what it was until they realized it was that gunfire.
I'm glad they're safe. Thank you.
Yeah. Thank you. Well, that family was staying at a hotel that was locked down, as was much of the Vegas Strip after the shooting. It is worth noting that one of the big questions in this investigation going forward is how the gunman was able to get that automatic weapon into a casino and hotel. Las Vegas, known for their tight security measures and facilities around the globe, have taken lessons from them on their operational security. Those questions are going to be looked at very, very closely going forward.
Flights in and out of the Las Vegas airport were halted during the height of the emergency. McCarran Airport tweeted some 24 flights were actually diverted then to other airports. Operations are resuming this morning. The airport advises you check with your airline if you are flying to or through Las Vegas today. And earlier we were talking about families not knowing about their loved ones. Facebook has activated its service where you can check in to see if you're safe. So if you just search Facebook for Las Vegas, you'll find it in there.
And it was hard to get a hold of the family. We couldn't call each other. They couldn't call me. Again, the phone lines were down, so we had to go through Facebook to call each other. But
And I did share that on my Facebook page as well, that finder where you can say you're safe and try to find your loved ones. Mm-hmm.